Shyanne, thank you very much for speaking to us. First of all, congratulations. How does it feel to be Miss Gibraltar 2014, now that you've had time to sort of let it sink in?
It still hasn't settled in, really. It still feels like a dream come true. I've always wanted to enter Miss Gibraltar since I was a very young girl, and I feel like I've achieved one of my dreams.
Excellent. And so what's next sort of in the immediate future for you now?
I've just signed my contract and I just got my official timetable. I have a lot of events and functions in the lead up to Miss World. I have photo shoots and also a video presentation in order to show Miss World where I come from and my background.
Excellent. That's very exciting. So tell us a little bit, sort of going back to the show, what are some of your favourite moments and the highlights that you can take from the whole experience?
One highlight would be the moment I first stepped onto the stage. The adrenaline rush that one gets, it's unexplainable.
Yeah.
And the audience was fantastic, and James Nash produced an amazing show. I also enjoyed coming out in bikini. That gives the audience a chance to see all the hard work and dedication that everyone's put into the show. The presentation was a very emotional time. It was a very personal reason why I chose the charity I chose.
Yeah.
So I had to compose myself for the 45 seconds. And lastly, the evening wear, very elegant, and you can show your personal style through your chosen dress.
Yeah, perfect. And looking back through the whole sort of process of meeting the girls and the rehearsals and stuff, what are some of your favourite moments from then?
One of my favourite moments was knowing that there would be a show, because as I was the first one to sign on, I was sort of looking back. If I look back now, and I think the show wouldn't have gone on without the 7 amazing girls. The first rehearsal was lovely. We got to meet one another. We got to see each other's personality, our background, and it was a really emotional roller coaster. We had amazing times, intense rehearsals, the photo shoots were amazing, and the experience overall would be one in which I'll never forget.
What are you hoping to achieve from your tenure as Miss Gibraltar?
I'll hope to achieve in becoming a good role model for the younger generations. I've said this quite a lot through the interviews I've done so far, but it's something that means a lot to me and it's very close to me at heart. I think to be a good role model for the younger generations, it's important because they can look up to someone and they can inspire not to be and follow my footsteps, but to be themselves and follow their dreams.
Excellent. So what would you sort of say to young girls who are thinking about signing up next year but are unsure?
I think sign up, and the most important aspect of Miss Gibraltar is don't listen to what people say. People are going to criticize you no matter what. There's going to be people who praise for some girls in entering, and there's going to be some people who wonder why have they entered. But everyone's entered because there's no, how would I put this? There's no set 10 out of 10 for beauty, because beauty is unique and everyone's beautiful in their own way. So I would recommend anyone who's thinking of entering Miss Gibraltar to go for it, even though you don't go home with a crown, but you go home with experience.
Do you have any aspirations beyond your tenure as Miss Gibraltar?
Yes, I aspire to be a qualified teacher. I hope to do my PGCE in the future, and I hope to qualify for special needs. Special needs is something that's very close to my heart. I really enjoy working with children with special needs. They always have a smile on their face, and I think everyone wakes up in the morning complaining about a bad hair day or the mascara's on badly. And we really need to think about at least we have what we have.
Yeah, put it in perspective.
Yeah, and I think they're always got a smile on their face because they don't know any better. And they're always willing and they're always helping. And I think they're really appreciative of any support that they're given. So that's very, very close to my heart.
The next big venture for you is Miss World. How do you feel about that? What are you hoping to achieve there?
It still hasn't sunken in that I'm going to Miss World. I like to raise Gibraltar's profile because I think even though we're a small country, but the size of our hearts overcomes the size that we are on a map. And we're such an amazing community. We're very warm-hearted. We're very helpful. We are a very welcoming community. So to raise our profile as much as we can.
Excellent. And I think we all saw the moment when you sort of had your crowning. moment at the show, and Marwa had a few words with you. What did she tell you? What advice has she given you?
I can't remember word for word everything she said, but one of the conversation that I remember having with her was her saying, "Are you ready? Are you ready?" I thought, "Yes, yes, I am." And then when she crowned me, the emotions that go through one's body is unexplainable.
Yeah.
It's a very, very proud moment. All my hard work and dedication finally paid off.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much for speaking to us.
You're welcome. Thank you.